May 4th, 2019. It was a really nice day. Sun was out. It was a Kentucky Derby, so everywhere was busy.
Me and my roommate were just joyriding around town, enjoying the day. And my moped had actually broken down, so we ended up riding double. We were heading down Loris Boulevard right by the college, just going down the steep hill. And we were just barely starting to head down the hill, and I saw this car kind of starting to pop out. And I knew she couldn't see us, and she just was turning left, and we were going down, and just like a smack.
My friend Bree was driving us, traveling down Loris. You go up and over the hill, up and over the hill, and then we had seen a person and a moped in the middle of the street.
Like, our bodies were flying. My roommate actually flew over the hood. And then for me, the handlebar went like this and inverted and punctured my groin and ripped up on my thigh. And I just got thrown to the ground. I remember being in a lot of shock and a lot of pain.
She called 911, parked the car, threw our hazards on, and basically just ran right to him. Well, when I approached, he had been, it looked like bleeding from the waistline, and you could just see it coming through his clothes. So it was pretty bad.
I was conscious through the whole thing, but I think I was in so much shock. I remember us freaking out because there's just a bunch of blood pooling on the concrete, and that was kind of scaring me because being a kinesiology major, like losing a lot of blood and you have major femoral arteries running down your leg, so I was a little worried.
I was like just trying to keep him awake, talking, make sure he's not moving too much. I yelled for someone to grab either a towel or shirt or sweatshirt or something that I could do to hold pressure.
I was kind of screaming on the ground, and Erin came over, and my roommate gave his shirt to her, and she just helped comfort me, and she was helping apply pressure to the blood and kind of just helping calm me down and relax until the ambulance came.
Within 2 minutes of us coming over the hill, seeing him, getting to him, calling, dispatch, I mean, it was a very quick process. I continued to hold pressure. They got him on the stretcher. They asked him his name, what happened, but they were more worried about getting him into the ambulance, so I just applied pressure until they were able to lift him and get him to the hospital.
They rushed me to the hospital, and then, they took an MRI and then got me straight into surgery. And it had actually missed my femoral artery. The doctor told me by an inch and a half, and if it would have struck that, he said I probably would have bled out.
Any job that I've ever had has always been to help someone in some type of way. I grew up with my dad on the city fire department, my grandpa on Asbury's volunteer fire department, my uncle on Dubuque's fire department, and now my brother on Dubuque Fire. So I guess it's just in our blood to help people.
If Erin wasn't there, first off, who knows how much more blood I would have lost, because she was really helping apply pressure to the wound. And I really think it speaks volumes to her character to come out and help me. I'd just like to tell her thank you, and I really appreciate what she did for me. Just an ordinary person. She had no clue who I was. But for her to come out and help me like that, it really means a lot, and I know it means a lot to my family as well. I have not been able to come in contact with her, but I look forward to doing so.
Well, we have a little bit of a surprise for you. We actually have Erin in the studio.
Oh, wow.
Hi.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. I'm glad you're okay.
Thank you.